Speed was Cassia's weapon. She must be swift and strike like lightning. Her small band marched through the night. At sunrise, they looked down on the pale roofs of Lorphus.
The morning sun will blind our enemies. You attack the city, and I'll free my men. Then we'll use a pincer movement like two reptiles.
Change of plans. One of my gladiators will go in your stead.
You don't trust me?
Someone has to guard our backs, and you're the only one I trust.
Well now, I suppose we should open as many cells as possible.
Thank you.
While the mercenaries freed their companions, Cassia and the rest fell on the city. Cassia's mask gleamed in the morning sun. Cowering in their homes, the people made signs to ward off evil spirits.
To hell with Marwyn, the creators and their hellspawn! Get the vermin under control, or you'll be deported to Duya and turn into vermin yourself!
and on we go.
After plundering the city, Cassia had the governor beheaded and sent his head to Marwan. Everyone would know that Cassia Corapia had challenged her husband, and that she would annihilate anyone who would stand in her way.
The shrunken head fits our Simon well. I bet it's exactly the right size for his brain. Do you remember, Haseki, how I once said I don't like to be disappointed? Why isn't she dead? I was assured she'd be dead.
A mistake, Your Eminence.
Yes, a mistake. Or fate. It's amazing you can still recognize him. My stupid cousin. Never really loved him. Is it inhumane to say that?
You are the first, Kyrios. You alone decide on humane or inhumane.
Now that's a burden.
Do you want to send out the cohorts?
And ruin my show of arms? Am I governor's not capable of dealing with my insane wife? No, I've got a better idea.
We've captured two carriages, Sahiba.
Anyone of note?
Well, one of them is a niece of the governor of Festina.
I remember the man, Baram al-Kumrat, one of Marwan's lapdogs. I hope his niece is brighter than him, at least. I'll question her.